الأسيس حنا دلي ريني الأسيس بلاد حبيبي
الأسيس أسيس خالد نلر والزرع الشماس هيفا الشماس جديد الصوت
مبروك
الصوت أجديك الصمائير
هو صمود
عندنا بالناصر مدير مدرسة بالناصر أمين السر أسيس حنا بماركة أيامكم طائفة الإنجليزية في عمان. دين كريك كوليج. دين كريك سان جورجس. كتير كوليج.
مسمى شو الماركت؟
هلو.
This morning to start our decisions in the presence of the Seyyidna is beatified, as he is present as a welcome of the group, the Anglicans, who will have it our retreat. Yesterday it was a big day at the cathedral by having three deacons. Today, of course, we'll start our retreat. And we have to say that our fellowship is great here, fellowship. And we feel that we are the body of Christ here in Jerusalem. And Jerusalem is a very important city, as you know, for all the whole world. And Sayyidna al-Batrak is making, you know, his focusing on the Christian presence here in the land very strongly. In the cities and towns, Palestinians, Jordanians, and here in Jerusalem. And we are with him in this mission, because this is a great mission, how to preserve the Christian presence in the land of the Holy Land. Sayyidna, it's our delight and pleasure to be with you this morning. And now, you want to say anything to that?
نسمع وجودكم بيننا في العائلة البطركية متصفين بس الإنجليزي انتم كلكم تفهم إنجليزي مصمت شاء الله Your Grace, dear Archbishop Tuhel, Your Eminences, dear Father Hussam, Reverend Fathers of the Anglican Diocese, We greet you warmly as we welcome you to the Rome Orthodox Patriarchate for the first time as a group, as one body. The Orthodox Church has enjoyed a centuries-long relationship with the Anglican Communion, and in Jerusalem we have known a close and mutually respectful harmony from the very beginning of the Anglican presence in the region in the 19th century. We take pride in the fact that our churches and traditions have maintained a good and open relationship in our region without conflict or suspicion. And our meeting today at this Patriarchate is a visible sign of the noble spirit that has existed in our life together. We wish to thank you, Your Grace, our dear friend Archbishop Suhel, for you have shown yourself to be a true and committed shepherd to your flock in the face of great pressure. You are, Your Grace, a valued member of the Head of Churches of the Holy Land, and we know that we can count on your support and collaboration as together we face the tremendous challenges that face the Christian communities of the Holy Land and throughout the Middle East. This is not what Jamal said.
It's not us here.
There are dangerous times when Christians must stand together against violence, prejudice, war, and terror. If we are still on the journey to the time when we may share of the one chalice, there are still many ways for us to express the unity that we already know between our two churches. One of the fruits of this deeper unity is your presence here this morning at the heart of the Mother Church, the Church of the Blood of our Crucified Lord, as well as the blood of St. James, the brother of the Lord and first bishop of the Church in Jerusalem. But the fruits of our closer unity are more abundant still. We share a crucial witness to the world of the central importance of Jerusalem, as you mentioned, Your Grace. It is our responsibility as the churches and Christian communities of the Holy Land to give priority in our ministry to safeguarding and protecting the holy places as the living sources of our faith, where pilgrims from both our traditions come for spiritual refreshment. We share a commitment to all the peoples of our region without discrimination. And both our churches welcome those of other traditions to our schools, clinics, and hospitals. We, who call the Holy Land our home, know the significance of Jerusalem. Jerusalem holds a unique place because she cradled in the bosom of her very earth the body of our Lord Jesus Christ. Here, death was vanquished and life restored. Jerusalem is the eyewitness of all these things. We share the responsibility to maintain the Christian character of the Holy Land in general, and Jerusalem in particular, and in this common mission is our unity also evident. We know well that Jerusalem and the church here cannot be an exclusive community for Orthodox or Anglican Christians alone. The church in Jerusalem must always be an ecumenical parish, within inverted commas. We can never conceive of ourselves as simply, inverted commas, a local parish, because we have the duty to give testimony to the sacred history, to the history of salvation. And so we must be a beacon of the light and truth of Christ to all, both to our friends and even to our enemies. Here in the Holy Land, we live the truth of the words of St. Paul in his first letter to the Corinthians. Do you not know that your body is the temple of the Holy Spirit within you, which you have from God, and that you are not your own? For you were bought with a price, therefore glorify God in your body. We understand that we are not our own, and that we have been bought with a price. In our commitment to our spiritual mission in the Holy Land, we seek to glorify God on our bodies and on our presence. Even in the darkest days of our history, the Patriarchate has kept undiluted and uninterrupted in the original apostolic tradition the philanthropic work of the Gospel, and the Patriarchate has resisted the attempts by political and social powers beyond us to influence this fundamental mission. In this work, we have welcomed many companions and fellow laborers, including the Anglican Church. And we know of the sacrificial ministry that many of you exercise in your congregations throughout your diocese. We stand ready to help you in any way we can, just we know that you are united with us in keeping alive the light of the hope of the resurrection of our Lord Jesus Christ. May you have a successful conference, and may God bless you, your grace, all your clergy and your families, your faithful, and all those who you serve. Thank you.
Thank you. Thank you. Thank you.
I wish I could say it in Arabic.
Thank you.
Please.
Maybe we need to know some Greek then.
Huh?
Maybe we know we need to know some Greek.
Everybody we'll knows Greek.
Everybody knows Greek.
We'll be more eager.
You know, the Kilvaluga, it's a Greek word. From Logos.
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 In Arabic there is no Luga.
No Logos.
In Arabic there is no Messiah.
It was to use for the New Testament. It is a very rich course to read the Gospel. The Greek is,
this is true.
Yes, yes, it's more powerful.
Right, because everyone has
strong beliefs.
Yes, because it's but we have now to learn Aramaic as well.
Aramaic. It's serious.
هاي مقدمة بس
فرنش تاخذ بطرس يا
بطرس
يعني بالوثائق التاريخيه في لسه جزء ثاني
لا مش تصريح
يعني
لا انا
النار
اصل اللي عم تحكي عنه اساسه هو وثيقه وثيقه
Your Grace, this is what was read a moment ago. This is only the introduction, right? The introduction.
No, this is the whole thing.
No, the details are not there. It's only the introduction, right?
Because the details, it's different.
How I understand that this is very important because of the Kashmir. You know, the Kashmir, they have their descent.
بس العهد العمرية سيدنا في العالم في عدة عهد بسموها كلها عهد عمرية بس في خلط بين إشي اسمه العهد العمرية لعمر بن الخطاب وفي عهد عمرية لواحد اسمه عمرو بن عبد العزيز هذيك سيئة شوي بحق المسيحيين مش
هذيك مش عهد هذيك الأحكام
أحكام مظبوط أحكام
لأنه العهد العمرية بتعود العمرية أعطيت لكل مدينة
أكثر من عهد
العهد العمرية was given to Damascus
بس أفضل من عهد
العمرية
بس الأفضل من عهد العمرية هي عهد رهبان طور سيناء
Because you have a retreat, right? It's too long here, maybe.
Thank you very much.
But don't show to your friends Muslims. They will take it away.
Thank you.
Because I love it.
Thank you.
They want that from us.
I know.
Love it.
I know. Everything is siyam, kul shemina. Wal iftar kamal minna.
Thank you.
Min ar-Rahman.
Thank you.
Yalla sora.
So, please. Father Hussam.
Tala Hussam.
بالصوت
بالصوت بالصوت بالصوت بالصوت بالصوت
هيك ابتسامة حلوة من الشباب.
شكرا.